Greetings, everyone. I am Dr. Wolf, and this is Enriching Your Relationship with FESP, with FESP standing for the financial, emotional, spiritual, and physical aspects of your relationship. In the last video, I talked extensively about the financial, and today I would like to focus on the emotional. And much like with the financial, spiritual, and physical, the emotional aspect of your relationship or your marriage needs to be kept in proper balance with the other three aspects. And the best way I can think to explain the emotional aspects and how to improve upon them is with the five love languages, because everyone expresses love and wants to be loved differently, and can have many different combinations on what they feel is most important when it comes to love languages. Now, the five love languages are words of affirmation, quality time, acts of service, giving and receiving gifts, and physical touch. Now, in my case, how I like to receive love is through words of affirmation, through acts of service, through physical touch. But in the case of my lady, she actually prefers to receive love through giving gifts, through quality time, and through acts of service. And yet, even though we have a very different variety of love languages, my lady and I have been able to make our marriage work for, it's been over 9 years now, because we have learned to express love in the way each of us wants to be loved. Now, here's a good example. Several nights ago, I felt incredibly compelled to clean house, because every once in a great while, I feel the need to scrub and sweep and clean out everything that I can see. And I asked my lady if she would be willing to help me in cleaning house. And it wasn't something that we had planned. It wasn't something that either of us had expected to do that evening. But because I felt compelled, yes, this is time. We need to clean house. I asked my lady if she'd be willing to help, and even though it wasn't part of her plan for the evening, she saw that it was important to me, and we spent a couple of hours scrubbing floors and sweeping and wiping down counters. We even took everything out of the fridge and got rid of a bunch of old stuff and wiped down every shelf and put everything back. And even though most people wouldn't consider that to be romantic, it's something that meant a lot to me, because if I was doing all of that myself, and my lady just had other plans for the evening or thought that there was other priorities she should be spending her time on, despite the fact that I asked for her help, it would have left me feeling frustrated. It would have left me feeling as though I was unimportant. So it made a real difference, because my lady was willing to use acts of service in order to help me. Now, by that same token, even though I prefer words of affirmation as a love language, my lady prefers giving and receiving gifts. And this doesn't always mean having a physical gift to give to someone. It could be the gift of your time, the gift of your attention, the gift of a long conversation, just listening to how they feel. And in many cases, what a person uses to express love is not always the same way they want to be loved. And this is something that takes time to learn. When you are getting into a relationship with someone, it's helpful to better understand what they enjoy most and learning to adapt to what they enjoy most. By that same token, it's helpful if they do the same for you. Sometimes there may be a day where words of affirmation don't really work, or acts of service aren't quite enough. Sometimes I really do want quality time where I can just escape from the stresses of the world. Sometimes that makes the real difference. A person's love languages can change depending on what's been going on in their day, or how they've been feeling over the course of the week. It takes time to learn. However, this makes a tremendous difference in the emotional aspect of your marriage. It can help you to better learn, I can put aside my own needs because my significant other is in great need of my help right now. This is what makes the difference, when you can forget yourself and get to work, making your significant other feel loved, feel needed, feel important. And it could be any combination of words of affirmation, or quality time, or acts of service, or giving and receiving gifts, or physical touch. It depends on the person. It depends on what's been going on in their lives. And if you are patient and persistent enough, if you can fulfill the other person's needs, it will help to raise the emotional balance in your relationship, alongside the financial, the spiritual, and the physical. It is something that I deeply believe in, and something that I sincerely hope many of you out there will learn as well. In the meantime, though, I would very much like to hear from each of you. For anyone who has been in a relationship, or better still, in a marriage, I would like to hear how the emotional aspects of your relationship have changed over the years, and what sort of love languages are most effective for your significant other, and how they express their love languages towards you. And perhaps it may help inspire others who follow after to learn from our experiences. Until next time, I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you.